Welcome back to my YouTube channel, guys. Good news this week. The borders of New Zealand are finally opening early next year. And so that means more travel. Immigration will start opening up. It's very, very exciting. And I will hopefully get a trip back to the U.S. in 2022. And so I'm sure things will change. COVID has just kind of got its new variant and it's getting a little crazy, but there's hope that we can be traveling a lot more in 2022. And so because of that, I thought there may be a lot of people moving here or traveling to New Zealand. I thought today I'm gonna give you the 10 most important things that I think that you should pack or bring, whether you're moving or visiting here, if you're coming to New Zealand. And these are in the order of the most important to the least important, because I know none of you get through my whole video. So 10 things that you need to be if you're traveling or moving to New Zealand. You're not going to miss this. Here we go. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Squarespace is a great all-in-one platform to get your business online quickly. Before we get started today, I just want to let you all know that in case you're not aware, if you are moving to New Zealand or traveling here for an extended period of time, I do offer consulting services where I'll meet with you on Zoom or whatever and talk with you and discuss your situation. I answer most general questions on my YouTube channel, but you want specific ones for your kids or schools or, you know, different specific things for you, book that. I will put the link below. And also, looking into next year, I am putting together possibly a webinar, some products that would be helpful to you. And if you want to click the link below, it'll bring you to a page where you can give me some feedback on, should I do this? Would this be helpful? What are some of the questions that you have? It's a little bit of a survey, a little bit of information just to tell me what is it you like, because I'd only like to create something that's useful to you and not waste a bunch of my time. But with that being said, let's get into it today. In my opinion, the number one thing that you should bring to New Zealand is a really good rain jacket that's windproof and rainproof, okay? The rain jacket, I would say, is the most important. Now, you can leave your umbrella, especially if you're coming to Wellington because it's so windy, there is no point. So have a raincoat that can deal with the wind and the rain. In my opinion, it's just the most important item that you bring. And I say this to so many people that are traveling here or moving here, and a lot of them don't really listen to me, or they just bring this really cheap poncho. No, go and get a nice rain jacket. You will thank me. Number two, really good shoes. Now, you don't have to get full-fledged hiking shoes. In fact, I recommend for like a traveling purposes is that you get those kind of like those ones that have, you know, some really good traction on the bottom, but also kind of look like a tennis shoe on the top. So they're not like they go up your ankles and it's like this huge shoe that you're clunking around all day on. But it's something that you can, that does really well on any sort of terrain and traction, but also, you know, something that you could just wear out normally on a day-to-day basis. So I highly recommend some decent shoes and make sure that they are very clean before you go through immigration here. And you have to have all of the dirt off of your shoes before you enter. So get some nice shoes, break them in, you know, don't wear them for the first time when you get here. And yeah, just be aware of the biosecurity. When you get into New Zealand, you have to have all of the dirt off of all of the items that you're bringing in, because that's how they keep this land so beautiful and pest-free and, you know, just things that don't belong in the environment here. So number two, good shoes. And number three, a hat, okay? Now I have lived here for 6 years and I cannot believe how bad I still am at this and making sure that my kids have hats, that I'm wearing a hat. You guys don't understand, the sun is really strong here and actually very dangerous. And so it's very important that you're applying your sunscreen and that you are wearing a hat. It's very important in New Zealand. So you're gonna want something that covers the front and the back and maybe the sides, and you're gonna be looking good when you're in New Zealand, but you won't have skin cancer. So that's good. So a hat is very important is number three. And number four, what I'm gonna have to go with, because I'm doing this in order of importance, is a day pack. Now, whether you pack a suitcase to come here or you have backpack to come here, you're gonna want a smaller pack to just take around on a day-to-day basis. You can't just be wearing
fancy purses. It just doesn't work. They're just the most beautiful parts of New Zealand are free, and it's just a lot of hiking or you know, just a walking tracks or going to the beach, and you just, you know, you're gonna wanna have a small day pack that you can pack your lunch in, water bottles, bring a water bottle in your day pack as well. And that's number four, make sure you have a day pack. And number five, very important, you're gonna need an outlet converter. So if you're coming from, you know, the Europe or the US, you're going to need, you know, the three prongs converter that we have here in New Zealand. And so with that being said, also be aware of the voltage differences. So don't bring things, if you're moving here and you're bringing stuff that have like, you know, I guess small, like little engines inside, or like blenders and mixers and those sort of things, I wouldn't bring it, because you have to get like a whole huge step down converter to plug it in. And then, yeah. And then you can use it without blowing it up, because it's 240 volt here and it's 120 in the US. Don't ask me about Europe, I don't know. And so just be aware of that. I know that there's ways to get it changed, and so it's not that hard if you really wanna bring it. But in general, if you're traveling, just make sure that you have enough of those so that you can plug in. You know, your hair curling irons are gonna be fine. Probably not your your hair dryers, because they're, yeah, that would probably blow. So don't bring that. Maybe just like your hair curlers at the most, your hair straighteners should be fine. But yeah. Outlet converter. And number six, I'm going to say that you're gonna need like a light fleece or like a jersey, just a thin one that can then fit under, say, your raincoat, or if you're coming in the winter and you're bringing more of a puffer coat to fit under there, just to layer up. It is very important in New Zealand. It can be very cold depending on what you're doing. So I'm just trying to talk general, no matter what you're doing, these are the things you have. Whether you're a backpacker or you're a luxury travel person, you should have some layers, okay? And so there's always good to have like that thin fleece material to have underneath that you can put on if it's extra cold, because it can be, depending on the time of year, very cold in the morning or very cold in the evening, and you're gonna wanna have that extra jersey or fleece protection. I don't know about you, but I have been putting off creating my website until I found my solution with Squarespace.
You guys are going to love this product. They have so many beautiful templates to choose from. You just pick your template and then you go in and just add the details of your business. And literally within one day, I was able to get my website up and running. Another feature that I love on Squarespace is that they have this social sharing where my community can just go right out into my YouTube channel, my TikTok channel, which is where most of my content exists. And so it's really nice that I can connect directly from Squarespace. Other features that Squarespace offers that are really great is the fact that you can collect donations, you can do email campaigns from it. It's just overall really great. I personally also love the analytics. I always like to know what's going on behind the scenes, who's really reaching me on my webpage, and that's just such a nice feature as well. I highly recommend that you check out Squarespace.
Take some time today to go to squarespace.com and check out your free trial. And then when you're ready to purchase your website or your domain, you get 10% off with the link below. Now, for number seven, I'm going to recommend that you bring some travel sheets and a small travel towel. Now, let me explain. So it's not unusual in like a batch here, which would be like a cabin or a cottage or you know, a home that you rent out on a lake or in the mountains, that you bring your own linens here and your own towels. And so whether you are backpacking, you're definitely gonna wanna have a travel towel, but if you're going to be staying in Airbnbs or some batches here, you're gonna want your own sheets, because they don't always provide that. So you don't want to be coming here and be stuck with that. Now, I wouldn't go out and buy it at the store either, because sheets are outrageously expensive here. So that's another topic. But anyway, my recommendation, you know, just like a set of sheets, just like probably small and thin, just something that you can pack with you, that you can bring depending on where you end up staying. It just gives you that flexibility without having to buy anything when you're coming to New Zealand. And number eight, I'm gonna recommend that you bring a shopping bag. At least have one of those ones that you can fold up real small, you know, in your purse that you can pull out, because there are no plastic bags here in New Zealand. You can't, there are paper bags, but they are so crappy. And like everything you put in just busts. So We're very sustainable here. You bring your own bags when you go to the grocery store. And so, you know, a lot of the places that you stay will have those for you and stuff. But like, just as a tip, I would just bring those really small ones. I always have one in my purse and I never regret it. Okay, it's so nice to have the bag in your purse when you're like, oh, I just picking up a couple of things at the grocery store and now I have something to put it in. So just bring a little shopping bag. And number 9, I'm going to say, bring your driver's license. I know that some people just bring their passport because that's, you know, what you need to travel around, but they don't always think about bringing their driver's license. And I'm going to say, bring your driver's license, because if you're going to rent a car, you can drive. So I can speak for Americans anyway. If you're an American coming to New Zealand, your American driver's license is valid for a year of traveling around here without having to do anything. You could literally get off the plane, go and get your car rental, and you could drive away. So bring your driver's license. It will come in handy depending on what you end up doing. I just think that's really important. Not everybody does that. Okay, and number 10, maybe think about some travel insurance. That's just always, insurance is like this necessary evil, is how I like to describe it. Like, it's so annoying having to buy it. We rarely have to use it, but you're really mad if you don't have it and you need it, right? Now here in New Zealand, if you're a visitor and you come and you get sick or something happens, you need to go to the emergency room, that's all covered with a small copay. So there isn't a lot of fear around healthcare as it would be if you were a foreigner going into the US and using their healthcare system. And it varies by country. So look into it. Like, I don't know all of the details about the travel insurance, but it's just good to have some protection over some of the important things that you're bringing, like your laptop and your phone and, you know, just everything that you bring really. And then also I just wanted to touch on money. So people are like, should I bring money? Should I bring cash? Bring a little bit of cash. If you have one of those credit cards or debit cards, you can generally pull things right out of the ATM at the airport. It's not a problem. Never had a problem, but I also have one of those credit cards that can be used internationally. Just kind of know what you're doing. And so that's important. And then also your cell phone, you can just get a SIM card right in the airport that will give you a number of normally you could buy like Australia, New Zealand region, and you can make phone calls here in New Zealand. Okay, so those were my 10 tips. So I had to think about all of them. Now there's a lot more than that, and you can find tons of great resources out there. Actually, the New Zealand Pocket Guide .com is amazing for if you're traveling here and you want some resources. It's great. I recommend that. I'll put the link below. But just know that these are just the top, if you're just thinking of 10 things that you don't want to forget if you're going to come here, you're welcome. So these are the ones that I recommend. And definitely check out my link below and let me know what you think would be helpful for me. Do you want me to do a webinar next year, maybe before everybody comes, and just, you know, talk through all of your questions? Is there a product that I could provide or an informational sheet? Let me know. I would really appreciate your feedback on that. It's just like a, just kind of a brief survey. And then also thank you for Squarespace for sponsoring this video. And don't forget, you get 10% off a domain or a website with them. And I love Squarespace. I use it for all of my businesses are on Squarespace. So I hope you enjoyed the video this week. Don't forget to comment below. Let me know any questions that you have or anything you'd like me to see do a video on, especially since I'm planning for 2022 and some of my videos. I got lots of ideas on things I could talk about, but I want to know what you want to hear because I am here for you. So subscribe below, video every week, and I'll see you next week.